everyone, thanks for stopping by. So for today's video, I'm going to share 7 steps with you on how to create your own YouTube channel. So to learn how to create your own channel, keep on watching. So the first thing is to pick a topic. And when you're thinking about this, think about it. What is it, the content that you want to put out for the whole entire world to see? Is it beauty? Is it mukbangs? Do you want to have something educational? Maybe some DIYs? Think about that. A good tip when picking up your topic is to think about something long term. What I mean by that is, what's going to make you happy for years down the road, maybe even days, months? For example, DIYs. I know that when I do DIYs on my other channel, I'm going to be very excited about uploading videos twice a week, maybe even, you know, once a week, every so often. When I'm in this channel, my lifestyle video, I know that I'm gonna enjoy any type of video that I put up that has to deal with lifestyle. And you also want to think about your audience, your subscribers. And what I mean by that is that the content that you're putting out for your subscribers is not for you, it is for them. How are you gonna help them? Does that make sense? So you want some raw, organic content. Now, tip number 2 is to think of a name and let it be a clever one. This is how you're going to brand your channel. For example, I decided to name my lifestyle channel, which is this one, Marissa's Endeavors, because for one, we don't know what we're gonna get into. Lifestyle is about many things in life to me. And it's about sharing with you, especially the way I wanted it to be, my life journey with you guys. And tips that I'm gonna have along the road for you that's gonna be beneficial to you. So step number 3 is, now that you've established your topic name, plan it out. And see, what I mean by plan it out is that I've learned the hard way. I would literally sit in front of the camera, I had an idea in mind, and I would just do it because that's just the type of a person I am. However, it just didn't ever really work out for me the way I wanted it to. When I started planning out my videos, I felt like I was a little more successful in getting the point across what I wanted to my subscribers. So if I was doing a DIY, I would literally just kind of sketch it out and then do it that way. I actually had all the materials that I needed. I wrote them down. I knew what I was going to need, so I would go to the store and prepare for it and then just film it. So I'm going to share you 3 things that are very essential to when it comes planning out my videos. The first thing is a planner, and this was a very inexpensive planner that I picked up at the Dollar Tree. And what I like most about it is that it just fits me, it fits my lifestyle and the way I organize in my brain and helps me to stay organized. So what I really like about this is that it's a very positive planner. Basically, it's like, you know, I've got big plans. When I open it up in here, it says start each day with a smile, you know, so things like that make me happy. And I've noticed that when you're happy and you kind of like things, you know, you have it's easier for you to plan. That's just me, that's my opinion. Everyone is different, so do what fits best for you. Okay, so now here I have November. This is the month of November. I have planned out pretty much. It's not completely full yet because as November progresses, then I have things that I add on there. And I do have a little bit of October here. And so what I like about this is that I can fit in or kind of more or less see the days where I'm going to be able to film. So on those days, I'll do just absolutely nothing but film, and then I'll pick another day where I am free, and then I will edit. So this is very helpful to me when it comes to planning out the days that I'm going to film. Now the other two are also little notebooks, and I have two of them because this one here I use for ideas. I constantly have ideas running through my head or just things that pop into my head. And so if you're forgetful like me, I will forget on the day that I want to film something what I was going to film. So if I have it jotted down, I can say, oh yeah, I wrote that down, that's what I want to film. Or if I have no idea, you know, what I really feel like filming, then I can go back to this book here and, you know, just pick something that's gonna fit with my schedule. And I picked this one up at Target, the Target dollar spot. It was $3. It's really a journal, but like I said, I use it just to jot down ideas. Now, the next one I also picked up at the Dollar Tree, and this is where the ideas come into what I have envisioned. This is where it kind of just all plays out. This is the playbook. And let me just kind of give you an example of what I mean by that. So on my other channel, I do a lot of DIYs. Okay, and so when I have an idea for a craft that I want to do, I have it already in my mind. I have it written down in my book. And you, of course, want to play it out to see how it's going to come out. So, for example, I used to just film. I would just sit down and just film. And, I mean, there's nothing wrong with that. But then there was things that I would forget to mention, or, you know, maybe certain instruction or directions, maybe some dimensions of things that I've cut, you know, that I forgot to include in the video. So when you, all my subscribers, or anyone who's watching the video, you know, want to maybe do, you know, this craft, then you really didn't know because I forgot to give that detail. You know, I forgot to say, well, this is how much I measured of this, and this is how much you're going to need. You know, so this is why I say, you know, you have to have some type of a playbook to bring that vision together. And I'm just going to kind of show you a little bit of what I do and what works for me. But don't laugh at my sketching. This is actually a boho feather wall decor that I've been wanting to do for a very long time. I had scraps of yarn because I love to crochet, just hanging out, and they were driving me nuts because I didn't have enough to crochet with, and I didn't want to, you know, for it to go to waste, so I needed to do something with it. So instead, I went in and did this. It's like a macrame but out of yarn, and I had a vision for it. You know, it was in my head, but I knew I had to sketch it out. So I knew exactly what materials I was going to use and more or less of how I wanted it to look, because I wanted it to look good for what fits for me in my house, you know, and this is what I came up with. So, you know, I was thinking maybe some little florals, but then that didn't end up working, and that's perfectly fine, you know, but, you know, the vision came together because I had already written down. So I hope this makes a little bit more sense and is helpful. Everybody organizes and thinks differently. This is just what works for me. So when I say plan it out, you know, plan accordingly to what fits best for you. Okay, so moving off on, you know, there's other ways of planning. Like I have here another notebook, and I literally kind of have like a little skit kind of written out for this video, purposely for this video, because I will tell you something. I tried to film this video twice before, and as I was going through the footage, I felt like I was all over the place, and I was. And so I really had to kind of get down in there and just, you know, kind of really write word for what I was thinking and what I was wanting to say, so I can make my point across. So when you have other types of videos like this, or that neat kind of like outlines, you know, you can have just a very simple book like this, and it doesn't have to be like an entire skit of, you know, what you want to say in the video, but more or less of an outline so that you make your points across. Because again, you have to remember that you want the information that you are giving up to be beneficial for your subscribers. It's not for you, it's for your subscribers. So keep that in mind. And again, do what works best for you. Okay, so step number four is to start filming. So I am filming right now from a camera. I have a Canon camera that my husband was so sweet enough to buy for me, but you don't have to necessarily go out and buy some expensive equipment. No, all you need is really your phone. So, I mean, if you have your phone, all you need to do is just use your video on there and, you know, just start filming away. I truly would recommend not buying any equipment or spending any money when you're first starting out YouTube. Just because you don't want to have to invest in all this right now, you have the time to do that later. So, my advice to you is, if you're thinking of starting a YouTube video, just pick up your phone, use your camera, and start doing it. Don't waste time. So step number five is to edit. And again, like I kind of just mentioned over and over so far, is don't go out and buy anything right now. Wait till the time is right to invest. And that even includes lighting. Like, I thought about investing in lighting, but I don't. I actually pick a day when it's nice and then I film. For the most part, I live in a city where it's always sunny. So, you know, you have to keep certain things in mind in there. But that's kind of just going off of what I'm talking about editing. Now, with editing, you can easily edit on your phone still. There are apps that you can just download on your phone. This goes for iPhones and Androids. There's two apps that I found that were very beneficial. They are called Inshot and Kinemaster. So those two actually have a lot of good reviews on them. And like I said, I want to provide information that's beneficial to you guys to kind of help you along your journey with starting a YouTube channel. And so when I was doing the research and I actually downloaded them, I just didn't look them up, I actually downloaded them, and they are pretty amazing. If I would have to ever have to edit on my phone, I would do so with either of those two. Honestly, in my opinion, I really like Kinemaster better than InShot, but they're just alike, kind of similar in very various ways. So again, it's really just going with what you prefer. If you're going to edit like I do on the computer, I get my SD card, I come into my computer and I film here, and I mean, I edit here. And all I do is use the free one that's Windows, I think it's Windows Movie Maker, yes. So it's Windows Movie Maker that I just use on here. I upload my video on there. I upload the footage on there and then I just start editing. Now, if you have a Mac, there's iMovie that you can, you know, edit from. I don't have Apple, so I cannot really talk from experience, but there's a lot of people that I know that have Apple and truly, truly love that. So on to step number six. And step number six is to determine a uploading schedule. So you want to be consistent when it comes to this. If you're going to upload your videos once a week or twice a week, you want to do them on a consistent basis on the same day. This is going to notify your subscribers, you know, to expect a video every Tuesday or every Thursday or maybe Sundays only, you know, depending on your time. Be consistent with that, and then be consistent also with the time frame that you upload the videos. And this is just to begin. Later on down the road, you know, you can obviously change your times, but this is just to kind of get you started and to being consistent so that you're actually starting your channel but you're gaining subscribers. And this is where I lack, but I'm okay with that. It's just because with the time that I have on my hands right now, it doesn't give me the ability to upload frequently like I would like to. So that's gonna change here pretty soon in 2020. But for the most part, what I did was on both of my channels, if you go in and visit them, you will see a little video that will pop up and will notify you on what my channel is about and what I do on each channel. And you know, the uploading schedule, the purposes of why I only upload occasionally. So I thought that that was very beneficial because it gave people who were just visiting my channel a little perspective of who I am. And you want to start building those relationships with people who are visiting your channel and who may not be subscribed right now, but you know, later on down the road, they're going to come across you and then they're going to subscribe. So tip number 7 is to upload onto YouTube, and if you haven't already created your YouTube channel, it's really easy, you guys, to upload that. I'm going to go on into my computer and I'm going to bring you with me so that you can kind of see what Marissa's Endeavors is about.
Okay, you guys, so I was going over my footage of when I filmed this, and yeah, so it wasn't that great. So I'm just gonna kind of review that again. So I just kind of wanted to show you how you can film from your phone. So this is a great example. I'm filming from my phone and I'm gonna upload it to edit. But this is my video Windows Movie Maker that I go into, and I'm gonna have something up right now. See, so I'm editing right now this video that you're gonna be seeing here very soon, and literally, you guys, it's really simple. So if you have Windows, I would suggest using this one, but I just wanted to show you a little bit of what it's like. And if you're going to use this one, you just add videos and photos here. Very simple, just play around with it. Again, get comfortable.
So here I am on my channel, and what I want to do is I'm going to click on my little picture right here, and I'm sorry if it's not a really good view. Let me just zoom in just a little bit there. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on my channel right here, and then it's going to take me to this. And so here, if I am new and I have no like art here or anything like that, I can go into customize channel. See this here where my little mouse is at? So that's where you will upload this channel art here. Here I can feature content, so like a video will be there. Again, for my new visitors, you guys will see, you know, here of who I am and so forth. And then I always go into about, because I want people who are visiting my channel to know what I'm about. You know, who I am, what this channel is about. So, you know, you can make it very simple, like this one's very simple.
So I have logged on to my Canva. Again, it's canva.com, and I'm going to leave that in the description box down below. And I've already created my account. So I signed in, and then here I'm just going to create design. You can also, you know, go into, just kind of scroll down, and then you will see all the different types of social media that you can do. So here, let me go back here. You know, you have your YouTube thumbnail, and then you have your YouTube channel art. If you, your channel art is if you want to add any pictures if you're just starting out. And then your thumbnails are what people are going to see when they're scrolling through YouTube. And so you can get through it that way. I, however, like to just go to create a design, and then it will pop up here on the side. And that's just easier for me. So if I wanted to go to create a YouTube thumbnail, I'm going to click on that. And then all of this is going to pop up. So they have different ones like music YouTube thumbnail, food YouTube thumbnail, beauty tutorial. So I'm going to go into the tutorial because this is a how to start your YouTube channel, and then you can just select anyone here. Well, on that, if you click down here, let me see, like here, this is going to say free. So I would suggest using these. Unless you upgrade, then they're going to, of course, give you more options to use.
So those are my 7 tips to starting a YouTube channel. I really hope this information was helpful to getting you guys started and kind of motivated to start it if you've been thinking about it. Don't think no more, but go in and just do it, you guys. It's gonna take time and practice. And most importantly, do not be scared. Like I said, I wish I would have started sooner, but you know what? I'm glad that I started anyways. And so that's my advice to you. Just start it. If you have any, you know, maybe anything that I need to kind of elaborate on, any questions or anything, do not hesitate to leave them down for me in the comment section, and I will try to answer them, you know, accordingly to help you guys get started. My email address, I'm gonna leave it down there too. Email me, you guys. I wanna help you get started on your YouTube channel. What's the best decision I've made? And I want everyone out there who is thinking about it just to start it. So if you like this video, don't forget to give me that thumbs up. And I'll catch you guys in the next video. Have a wonderful day. Bye.